industry.
Yeah. I think panelists are I think Dr. Ganeshwar Rao, Dr. Shastri is not here. Other Dr. Dayal Singh, Sai Krishna Rajkirti Rao on the dais. This is a very day, starting from the retired professor to youngster who has green horn. So everybody is there. So I'm in middle ages. So this panel probably represents the correct proportion of pediatric dermatology from the old to young. So let us see. So topical steroid, you know, when you are dealing with an atopic child, they will come to you first. They may not come to dermatologist first. So then we start writing something. Usually we start topical steroid. Then what is the steroid of choice? How long to use on the face? But because infantile eczema firstly occurs on the cheeks. So to avoid atrophy, how long you can use it safely? Dr. Sai Krishna?
Sir, choice milder steroid on the face, because longer use can has problems, especially near the eye, can cause damage to the eye. So I tried to restrict using steroid for a very short course of time, not more than 2 weeks.
Which steroid for 2 weeks?
I would prefer to use hydrocortisone or desonide. Is the primary choice. Beyond that, if sometimes the eczema is too much and where it is very stubborn, too much of lichenification, it is rare to see lichenification on the face. But
the question is on the face, no lichenification.
So no lichenification on the face, then these are the...
Okay, 2 weeks of hydrocortisone or desonide to avoid any complications. Do you think it's correct, Dr. Ganesh?
It can be used up to 3 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, because that is the period where when the atrophy we expect, particularly on the face. Not only that, we need to use emollient sometime. One time you can use emollient and the other time you can use steroids. So that's the reason why you use only the hydrocortisone.
Hydrocortisone plus emollient. Okay.
Yeah.
Now you get a child with a scaling on the scalp. So we have a doubt. Is it seborrhea or atopic dermatitis? What do you think, Dr. Dayal Singh? What is this condition?
Sometimes atopic and seborrheic lesions will be present, but anti-seborrheic treatment will relieve the lesions, but atopic lesions continue and there will be increased pruritus.
So you clinically, this is USA therapeutic test you are telling. So only by therapy you will know that. Clinically can we make it? Yeah, Dr. Raj, do you want to add?
How before 6 months, we should suspect, before 3 months, in an infant, we should suspect seborrheic, because the maternal hormones will be there. After 3 months, atopic is the thing. But usually, we can see an overlap between atopic and seborrheic scalp conditions too. Either in those conditions, we see for the greasiness on any other areas of seborrheic involvement, then we go for the ketoconazole, topical ketoconazole applications, and in case shampoos also should be used, preferably a steroid-based shampoo.
So because of the maternal hormones, so seborrhea is likely to come under, as long as the maternal hormones have influence on the child's sebaceous glands. That's the answer. Okay. So that means you are telling about ketoconazole shampoo for an infant?
No, sir. Actually, I mean for the child, in case of the seborrheic, after 6 months.
Okay.
After 6 months.
Then what is this? You have steroid shampoos also nowadays are coming.
Yeah, we have this fluocinolone-based shampoos, and it's more convenient for the lathering effect, and this one also. It removes the scales off and a short contact time. But more amount of applications are helpful than the steroid-based shampoos. But this somewhat eases the scales and the inflammation also, sir.
Anti-inflammatory action.
Anti-inflammatory.
Yeah, Dayal Singh.
Steroid shampoos, they are anti-pruritic, anti-inflammatory, and they decrease the lesions. And especially in because scratching is less, in suppose it's a psoriasis, then copnospinema will not be seen.
Yeah. You want to add anything? So. steroid shampoos?
Generally, I don't prefer personally.
You don't prefer shampoo. Because it's expensive, too expensive.
Too expensive and it has
some. For a drug to be given as a shampoo, it may be wasting
moreover, any
10 times the money of.
Yeah. Any doctor or person has to stay there to have an.
But somebody can afford, you can give steroid shampoo, So.
Short context of topical shampoos with steroid. Even after short content and rinsing with water, it has the effect of stay-on lotion.
Okay. Now, you have various formulations, creams, lotions, gel, etc. No? So I think pediatricians, particularly youngsters there in the back benches, so they are all getting confused. Why should we use, why, when, how and all. So, Sai Krishna, you think, what do you prefer in a child, cream or lotion or gel?
Again, condition will decide whether if it is to be cream, lotion or gel or the area of place where we are applying.
Yeah.
Suppose lotion.
Cream on?
Cream can be applied over normally everywhere.
Yeah.
But ointments
everywhere. Okay.
Ointments cannot be used on wet lesions.
Messy. Okay.
Messy. Yeah. And then lotions can be applied for hairy areas. Sometimes the preparation also varies. Ointments are more potent compared to creams and other formulations. Lotions can be very drying, so if the skin is very dry, then lotions are not so preferable. So, according to the skin condition.
According to the size and skin conditions.
Area of involvement.
Area, how much is the area involved? For scalp, you give a lotion. And for cream for everywhere, and for thick areas you give ointment, you said, no? You can't give ointment for
oozing lesions
and?
Gels have anti-astringent effect, so that they are mostly used for sunscreens and all the face, oily skin.
A child will not have an oily skin, no?
No.
Yes. In a child, we are talking about pediatrics here.
Keratotic areas, we use more amount of ointments.
Preferably
wherever the lichen condition is there, that is the choice where we use the ointments.
Ointments gives more penetration of the steroid. But then you can't use it in a fold and, as you said, and oozing areas. That's the thing. That's the message to the youngsters there. So when do we give occlusion? Sometimes we are occluding also, some atopic child with a large area of surface. You are occluding.
But in such conditions where there is lichenification, probably you will go for the ointment and the occlusion.
Ointment itself is an occlusive effect.
Added to that, you can go for the occlusion, which enhances the penetration.
Dialysing?
Recalcitrant dermatitis or palms and soles and localized lichenified lesions.
Thick areas where the penetration is less, you need occlusion. That's what you're meaning,
But this cannot be used for long period. Occlusion.
That's the next question. How long is that's a different thing. Where do you use this? Occlusion, of course, you can't keep on using, so once it starts improving. Then we heard this word of tachyphylaxis. After some time it won't work. Is it real or myth? And if it's real, how do you deal with it?
There are two schools of thought. There is one school of thought which thinks that there is the action of steroid is there. Initially there is rapid action of the steroid, then there is a plateau, then sustenance is there, and after that the patient doesn't use it. So which results in the non-action of the steroid. So that's one thing people generally believe that.
Mostly seen in potent steroids.
Potent steroid won't work after some time. Then you
will
have a stagnation
holiday, which will increase the upregulation of the.
What is the time period to get that? How long you use?
It can happen if potent steroid without occlusion 1 week and with occlusion 1 week, without the occlusion 2 weeks.
Within 2 weeks, you should get results. What do you say, Rajkiran?
Yes, sir, I agree with the 2 weeks thing, but we should always keep an eye whenever the patients come back and saying unresponsiveness. In that case, we have to stop the steroid for 4 to 5 days, give it a break, and then we can restart it or we can upgrade it, updose it or downdose it based on the situation and based on the intensity of the eczema.
So, yes, there is a scientific basis. I think most of this work is done in BHU Dr. Pandey and Dr. S.K. Singh, my friends, they have done this topical steroid experimental study. They have found that this vasoconstrictor effect will calm down, it's not be there. So you give a gap and restart, it starts working. Or you change the steroid. That's the scientific basis for this word. So it's not that the doctor is bad. Sometimes after 2 weeks, if it doesn't work, probably patient has developed a tachyphylaxis to that particular steroid in that area. So you are dealing with changing the steroid or stopping and restarting. Okay. Yeah, milder one. Yeah, okay. You change the steroid, the molecule you are changing. Now, when you use extensively topical steroid, how much is the safe quantity and how much is the safe duration? You take it? Yeah. Pediatrics. Yeah.
The quantity is a fingertip unit squared. The amount of cream or ointment which is expressed from a 0.5 centimeter nozzle which covers the length of the adult index tip of the index finger to the distal interphalangeal crease. It weighs about around 0.5 grams and two finger tip units will cover the area of two palm area.
No, the question is how much is this safe?
Safe is with the steroid which low potency steroid which gives the effect in the least minimum time.
Yeah.
That is the
Dr. Ram?
Body size 15 grams. 15 grams per week can be safely used.
15 grams per week is a safe limit. Yeah. You want to say
that depends on the area also.
Area
of involvement and periodic age group, the body weight to body surface area. And so the absorption will be more, so lesser quantity is required in children.
Yeah. So the rule of adult may not be valid in periodization. Yes. Periodic
monitoring
skin surface.
Yes, sir. Okay. And if there is a doubt, then you have to.
No, you take it. Not able to hear, I think. Yeah.
If there is a doubt, then. If long term has been used, then cortisol levels have to be checked.
So systemic absorption, you are telling that it can result in systemic absorption, SVA, depression.
Okay.
So that means how long? That's the question they want to know. How long?
The condition.
2 weeks or 4 weeks or 8 weeks?
No, sir. The skin condition again describes the use, sir. It is a lichenoid skin and all absorption is less, but if it is a woolly skin and the under occlusion, the absorption is more.
So like an indication in infant or young child, you don't
get. If we say on an average, you can't exceed 2 weeks at a stretch.
2 weeks, yeah. More than 2 weeks.
10 to 15 grams per month, I think, can be safely used without having iron set. But all the things are determined by the surface area, the type of skin lesion. So all those things are important.
So various factors are different in a child, okay. So you cannot apply the same rule as adult where say 30 grams or even of clobetazole per week is which results in systemic absorption. Yeah, it's not moving, yeah. Now, do you get allergy to the topical steroid also? Contact allergy?
Yes, they can. Yeah. Particularly non-fluorinated steroids.
Yeah. Then how do you diagnose?
No, the patient, you expect the adequate response for the steroid will not be there. And so you will be worrying why the particular molecule is not working.
Yeah.
Then there could be some amount of itching, allergic phenomena can be visualized, like erythema, other things can be seen. So particularly these things can be shown in hydrocortisone and the budesonide, which are non-fluorinated hydrocortisone.
Okay.
Especially the preservative is paraben causes.
Yeah. So it may be steroid or is the parabens which are there in the creams. Yeah, that's the reason why ointment probably is safer. So there is no preservatives in an ointment. Okay. When do you expect Cushing syndrome with topical steroid? That I think you have answered that question. So depending upon the absorption. Widespread application, yeah. Now for cradle cap. Now what is the ideal topical steroid if you want to use a topical steroid?
1% hydrocortisone is like. Once with along with the ammonia.
Cream or lotion?
Cream.
Cream, okay. Yeah. That is safe, okay. 1%. Hydrocortisone is the safest for a child with the cradle cap, yes. Oh, topical steroid plus antifungal plus antibiotic, C plus G plus N, N plus C plus D. So you see various combinations, permutations. Now what is your take on this?
No, this has to be curbed strongly because we do not know, these are the molecules that are used mainly for the undiagnosed conditions. So when you are not sure of your diagnosis, please don't use steroids or don't use any antifungals or antibacterials. Please go for any emollient and wait for some time to manifest so that you know the what is the clinical picture, clear-cut clinical picture that comes out, rather than going to dumping all the three molecules like hydrocortisone or steroid and antifungal and antibacterial. Ultimately nothing happens. Ultimately when the next person sees, next physician or next pediatrician or next dermatologist sees, ultimately he also will not be able to diagnose. Yes. So ultimately this has to be strongly curbed, the usage of the combinations. As it is, government has already banned all these products which have the combinations.
Majority of skin conditions, they are responsive to only steroids. There is no need of antibiotic creams, and other thing is some of the combinations have potent steroids. When applied to the groin area, they cause strain and other problems.
The thing is, proper lack of examination of particular areas, the other satellite lesions, other things, usually the other physicians tend up ending up with this kind of prescriptions. But ultimately, after we examine the patients after such a long time, because they get the over-the-counter medications are freely available with them, so we are seeing a lot of atrophy on that.
So specific diagnosis, a specific treatment, yeah. So now we have a specific diagnosis of pyoderma. Which topical antibiotic is ideal?
Sir, I choose Mipirocin, sir.
Mipirocin, straight away.
Yes.
Dr. Dayal,
you can start.
Yeah, first, Mipirocin is next is specific acid, and also now latest is Rifampicin also is being used. But first is Mipirocin.
Rifampicin.
Why not promycetin or neomycin or bacitracin?
No, because there are sensitizations, sir. Lots of sensitizations can happen with that.
Yeah. No, sensitization is more common with the molecule which are
antibiotics. So, when for example, pyoderma, is it not enough to be topical only? No, when there is the lesions are more and lymph nodes are present, then we need your system.
Like and subscribe Eagle Media Works.